Good afternoon, my dear brothers and sisters. So, my lecture will be on Ahara Pachyo. Ahara Pachyo, Ahara Nutriment. According to Patana, or in some of suttas, Ahara Nutriment is two kinds. One is nutriment for thought, nutriment for physical bodies. Two types are like food for thought, food for the body. So two types of alike. Imbatana will be explained in two kinds of food, nutriment. Bhokta Mansupama Sutta. Simile of flesh of sun. Majjhima Nikaya. Bhokta Mansa. Flesh of sun. Bhokta Mansa Upama. Upama means a simile. Bhokta Mansa Upama Sutta. In this sutta, the Buddha explained four types of nutriment. The other suttas also have such a, but this sutta is completed the meaning. And Bhidhima texts also say four nutriment, chattaso ahara, sattaro ahara. So ahara, food for thought, food for the body, nutriments too. Here also will be explained the two aharas. Four aharas. What are the four aharas? Food for the body is called kavalikara ahara. Kavalikara ahara. Nutriment. Kavalikara ahara. Eatable food. Eat it for food. The food for the body. This also kapri karo. And last, the last line in ahara pachyo, the last line we say kapri karo aharo imasa kayasa ahara pachena pachyo. This one. Kapri karo ahara. Kapala karas, kapala kara, kapala's morsel with measurement of the mouth, one morsel, make morsel. So kavali karo ahara, that is referring to food, dairy food, I want to say, to treatment. The remainings are belonging to food for thought, mineral food, nutriment, or they are pasa, pasa, gandak, mineral state. One of the mineral state is pasa, gandak. It makes mind to communicate upset. One of the middle street, every mind has fasa, contact. This also save food for thought, mineral nutriment. Without it for fasa, no feeling, no taste is possible. So, fasa pachaya virana in Patijasvabhara said. Depending on fasa, the feeling rises. So, fasa brings about virana. Bring about virana. Therefore, fasa is called ahara, the kind of ahara. Fasa brings about virana, fasapajaya virana. Therefore, fasa is food for thought. The Mano Sanchetana. According to this term, Mano Sanchetana. Mano Sanchetana. Mano Sanchetana also. Mano Sanchetana is Chetana. Mental volition. Mano Sanchetana. It is a chetana volition. But here down is sanchetana. With the word mano, mano sanchetana. This term is used, mano sanchetana. That is also food for thought. Want to say this as a chetana? Okay? Chetana ham bhikkhave kamma vadami. According to it, Chetana brings about relinking questions, relinking, bringing about path, brings about the rebirth. Chetana brings about rebirth. Therefore, it is called ahara nutriment. Because here ahara literally, ahara means bring in the effort. Literal meanings, ahara means bring in effort. You see, food also bring in effort. Food is bring about, it is effort. Therefore, ahara literally bring in. Aharadi. Haradi. Haradi means taking away. Aharadi means bring in, bring, take, bring. Haradi, take. Aharadi, bring. Because of ahara. Take and bring. And Bali is changes. Only with the prefix, A is a prefix. Just haradi is take away. Aharadi is bring in. Bring here. This way. Like that, this prefix is meaning changes. Like English, A also meaning changes. No? Synchronous, asynchronous, you see, meaning changes. Theism, atheism, changes. Theist, atheist. In Bali also, you see, Dadati. Dadati means give. If with the prefix a dadadi means take, give and take. Dadadi, give. Adadadi, take. Meaning changes. According to the preface, A is changes in this way. So samvas are very similar. That is human ideas. Similar ideas. Haradi, aharadi, dadadi, adadadi. Seti, sayati. Sayati means conquered. Prasayati is defeated because of pra. Pra changes. Negative meanings give here. Jayati, prajayati. In Pali, the prefixes are used to change the meanings. Altogether in Pali is 20 precepts, 20 altogether. That is called upasaka or upasara. Upasara. Preceding of words. You see, Buddha Saranang Gacchami, this Gacchami. And normally it is a Gacchati. Gacchati means goes. Agacchati is coming. Agacchati. Okacchati is going up. Okacchati means going down. Only gacchati, you see. Many. Nekacchati means going out. Nekacchati. So according to the preface, the meanings are changed. Here increase the meanings. Going up, down, out, going, coming. The words are invented. Interesting, this Pali language also. If you wish to learn Pali, is interesting, this some words accordingly, you see. To have the knowledge of language is very useful. It's essential. Pali essential for learning Buddhism. It's even very important to know Pali because of the Buddha explained in his profound Dhammas in Pali language. So Pali language is important to those who wish to know the Buddha's teachings. Own language is maybe lead to misunderstanding. Language is sometimes not good enough, any kind of language. If you translate the word the essence of words spoiled, destroyed. The normal language is better, you see. If it translated, it's not a good enough. Maybe understanding is possible, but not fully understand. Fully understand is only old language is fully understand. What is it? Originally used language. Originally. For example, mata. Why is it called mata? In Bali have the meanings. Mata is mother. Why is it called mata? Mata is a so-called because if you cherish hard time, cherish hard time. Therefore it is called mata. What is it, the meaning of mata? Mata is mata. Mata is mata. In this way, Pali have its meaning. Maybe other languages also have their meaning, but we don't know about it. Pali has literal meanings, have with the literal meaning. Pita also have, father also have a meaning. Brothers, sister, everything has its meanings. In this way, ahara also have meaning. Not only nutriment, not only food. Bring about. So, manosanjetana. Manosanjetana also, mental food. It brings about rebirth. Rebirth is mean consciousness. Bodhisattva is consciousness and a relinquishing state. Bring about the relinquishing state. Then the last one is vijnana, consciousness. Vijnana also ahara, food for thought. Why does it become food? Vijnana brings about nama rupa. Vijnana pachaya nama rupa. In Patijasvapara. When vijnana abhiyade, it is caused to rise nama rupa. Vijnana is a leading factor. So, vijnana brings about nama rupa. Therefore, it is also food. According to this point, what about avijja? Avijja paccaya sankhara, sankhara paccaya vijnana, vijnana paccaya nama rupa. They are also bring about their result. They are also can be called ahara. Yes. Anguttara Nikaya used such a avijja, sankhara, vijnana, namarupa, aura, all type of causes are called ahara. But not in 24 conditions. 24 conditions, only these four. Because of these are special, the others are general. Now special, general is everywhere, you see. Now Bhatana lecture is a special lecture. Because of the profound Dhamma. Explanation, the base of Abhidhamma. This is not a special. Prathana is a special. So in this way, ahara, conditional relation is special here. As a special, ara is only four. Aras are only four. Okay? Special. Because why it is special? Without the food, nobody can sustain their life. It's a Shiva. Without the food, nobody life. Nobody can be alive. So food, nutriment sustained the life of beings. So that is also special. Without the food, cannot they remain? There are four conditions, four causes of metta, material quality, kamma, citta, uttu, ahara. Out of these four, ahara sustain the body. Ahara sustain. The others are also according to their effect. But after become sentient beings, for human beings, you see, without the food, nobody can sustain their life. Food is important. Therefore, every day people are searching for food. Even animals are searching for food. So, food is important to sustain their life. Therefore, kavalikara ahara is a special ahara for sustain of the beings. Then phasa also special condition, because to live longer in samsara, phasa is important. Without the phasa, no feeling. Without the feeling, cannot be enjoyable, cannot be enjoyed. Because of feeling, people enjoy. Therefore, enjoy longer in samsara. Life is too short, enjoy yourself. Because of phasa, you see. Without the phasa, there's no enjoyable. So phasa is important. This is a special condition, therefore called ahara. Not just a condition, special condition, therefore ahara. What about the manosanchetana? That is also very important. If there is no pollution state, no karma, manosanchetana is a karma. If there is no pollution, rebirth is impossible. Rebirth is impossible. Therefore, rebirth also necessary, because only one birth cannot live longer. Rebirth. Renews, even visa renews, you see. Visa extension. Otherwise, visa expire. So, we also renewed. Rebirth. Renewed, expire will be. So, after 80, 90, expire. The beings also become expire, not only visa, expire. This also, not only medicines expire, not only foods expire. We will be expire. Expire is a necessary rebirth. Otherwise, cannot be enjoyable. in samsara. Rebirth, refresh, renew. So always the people say Happy New Year. Every New Year they happy. Not Espanya years. Nobody say Espanya year. Even don't say goodbye. Goodbye 1940. Only Happy New Year. No, have to say. Only New Year they will come. New Year work. Always the people, you know, very funny. Always. Many people are desire for new. Aura, new. So that is also the cause, the condition. That it brings new is important. Therefore, Chetana is a special ahara for rebirth. Therefore, the Buddha says, the Buddha knows everything, you see. Considering any corner. So, vijnana. Without a vijnana, there is not mind body coming to being, vijnana pachaya anama rupa. You should feel just vijnana, you say spirit. Spirit waiting for chance for next life. Just a spirit, you afraid as a ghost. So, when vijnana does not bring nama-rupa, how to feel? So, vijnana brings about nama-rupa. This form is appear, feeling appears, everything is okay. Therefore, vijnana is a special condition, special ahara. So, just condition, just cause, cannot be say ahara. Only special cause are called ahara. To maintain in samsara, to prolong in samsara. These food, these food for thought, food for physical bodies are brings about prolonging the beings in samsara. Therefore, many beings are joining together very happy. They together very happy. So many association. The many associations. Have you made war is forever crowded. Anyway, kingdoms forever crowded. They enjoy each other. Happiness. Chanting, temple, you see, singing, enjoying in this way, you see. These are special conditions for such a situation. Therefore, they are called ahara. Without these, you see, impossible. Life is impossible. So, ahara pacheo. Kusalo dhammo, kusala sa dhamma sa ahara pache na pacheo. Ya. Kusalo dhammo, kusala sa dhamma sa ahara pache na pacheo. You should know these three. What are the food for thought? Food for thought. Pasa, chetana, vijnana, pasa, chetana, vijnana, context, volition, and consciousness. Okay, these three are ahara. These are mental state and consciousness. Vijnana is consciousness. Pasa, chetana are mental state which associate all type of consciousness. Wherever consciousness appears, they associate. Therefore, you treatment. So, kusala ahara. The ahara belong to kusala, want to say. Ahara belong to kusala means, you see, all kusala chaitas are ahara. Consciousness is ahara. The among associated mental state, pasa is ahara, chitana is ahara. Referring to these three, here say kusala, ahara, samyuktakana. To clarify it is, for example, kusala chaita is one of the kusala chaita. Generally speaking, one of kusala chaitas, as a measurement number, kusala chaita is one. Then, the association mental state, associated mental states are 38. Altogether, 39. 39 is one unit. Among the one unit, we must take out the consciousness one, and pasa one, chitana one. So out of 39, this becomes 36. The remaining is 36. So okay. So the three is ahara. The remaining 36 are samyuktaka dhamma. Okay, they are co-nations, born together, reciprocal, anyamanya, associated state, sampayuta. Not a belong to object, they born together, or there is a belong to sahajata, co-nations. So, according to Hetu Pachyo, you remember Hetu Pachyo, Kusala, Hetu, Samyuktakana, Kanana, Hetu Pachyo, Na Pachyo, the same things. Here, Kusala, Ahara. Kusala, Hetu, Alava, Adosa, Amoha, there. Here, Kusala, Ahara means Chaita, Pasa, Chaitana, Vijnana. Okay, Pasa, Chaitana, Vijnana. These are kusala chitta, ahara. So, accordingly, we have to say in this way, pasa chitana vinyana. So, wholesome kusala dhammo, wholesome state is related to the wholesome state by nutriment condition. By nutriment condition. Then, clarifying it. Kusala ahara samyuktakana khanana ahara pachena pacheyo wholesome nutriment wholesome nutriment are related. Kusala ahara, wholesome nutriments are related, they are associated, aggregate by nutriment condition, supporting each other. Because of these three sustained the remaining. These three sustained the remaining. Chutu, the bhavara, the three, the remainings are sustained. So that is the meaning. Then next point, kusalo dhammo abhyagata sa dhamma sa ahara pache na pacheyo. Wholesome state is related to indeterminate state by nutriment condition. Kusala ahara chaita samudhana na rupana ahara pache na pacheyo. Wholesome nutriment are related to mind-produced metta by nutriment condition. Because as soon as these phasa, chetana, vijnana is coming to being, it produces metta also the same time. Therefore, this also, in this case, kusala aharas are kusala. Aharas are kusala. They protect, produce the metta, which is produced are abhyagata. Metta is abhyagata. So joining these two, mixing these two together, kusala dhammo kusala sacca abhyagata sacca dhammasa ahara pajena pajeyo. Wholesome state is related to the wholesome state and indeterminate state by nutriment condition. Kusala ahara samyuttigana khanana chaita sodhana ca rupana ahara pajena pajeyo. Wholesome nutriments are related to their associate aggregate, and mind-produced metas are also by nutriment condition. Oh, nutriment condition. This way. This first and second joined together. In the same way, this belong to akusala, similar to kusala. Okay. Akusala dhammo akusala sa dhamma sa ahara pache na pacheyo. Unwholesome state is related to the unwholesome state by nutriment condition. Akusala ahara samyuttigana khanana ahara pache na pacheyo. Unwholesome nutriment are related to their associated aggregate by nutriment conditions. Then second, akusala dhammo abhyagata dhammasa ahara pache na pacheyo. I think you can memorize. Huh? You maybe always memorize these things. You can recite without a look in books. So, okay. Several times you see such a sound. Akusala dhammo abhyagata dhammasa ahara pache na pacheyo. Unwholesome state is related to the indeterminate state by nutriment condition. Akusala ahara chaita smudhanana rupana ahara pachena pacheyo. Unwholesome nutriment are related to the mind-produced metas by nutriment condition. They join it first and second together. Akusalo dhammo akusala sacca abhyagata sacca dhammasa ahara pache na pacheyo. Unwholesome state is related to unwholesome state and indeterminate state by nutriment condition. Akusala ahara samyuttigana khanana chaita smudhana ca rupana ahara pache na pacheyo. Akusala unwholesome nutriment are related to the associated aggregate and mind-produced matter by nutriment condition. Okay, the last ones. Abhyagato dhammo abhyagatasa dhammasa ahara pache na pacheho. So, indeterminate state is related to the indeterminate state by nutriment condition. Vipaka vyagata, kriya vyagata, ahara, samyuktikana, khanana, chaita smodana, jarupa, ahara, pachena, pachena. Because of both are mind, metta, asa together, therefore vyagata, similar. Vipaka vyagata, kriya vyagata. So, resultant, indeterminate, functional, indeterminate, nutriment are related to. They are associated, aggregate, and mind produce metas by nutriment condition. That is a poverty. You remember poverty, our lifespan. Abdapati Sandhi, the whole lifespan is called poverty. Life continuity, poverty. Then just relinking moments is called Bodhisandhi. Bodhisandhi in poverty, two durations, our lifespan. So, Bodhisandhi kane vipaka abhyayata. Yeah, at the moment of relinking, relinking moments is just only resultant, no function, no kriya function. Therefore, at the moment of Bodhisandhi, at the moment of relinking, vipaka vyagata ahara samyuktikana khanana gadatta jarupa. So Bodhisandhi chaita cannot produce mind produce metta, cannot cause, cannot produce any chaita for metta. Because chasabhiya cannot do another works. Not enough power to produce. Therefore, Bodhisandhi chaitas cannot produce chaita bho metas. So at that time, only kama bho metas. Kama bho meta produced by kama, not by chaita, by mind. So at the moment of Bodhisandhi movement, resultant indeterminate nutriment are related to their associated aggregates and karma produce metta, gadatta ca kamana, by nutriment conditions. So there is three types of food for thought. It's finished. Mental food. Then natural food is coming here. Kavalikaro, aharo, itivo. Itivo means the ahara is just put in the cup, just a cup, just put in the cup. Cannot produce effect. After chewing and swallow, you see. In the stomach, not in the cup, not in the bowl, monk's bowls also. Therefore, kavalikaro aharo, and to say. Kavalikaro aharo, kavalikara. The make morsel, literally is make morsel, kavalikaro aharo. Kavala means morsel. According to our mouth, measurement of our mouth, we prepared food and put into the mouth. Using spoon and fork and chopstick. Our hand, so figures use many ways. That is a call, Kavalikara. Kavalikara means in this way. To put in the mouth, media. Media is a chopstick, a spoon and fork, or hand. Some people are open their house, the others stone. So anyway, what about cows, grass, how they are cutting with their mouth? Monkey also using their mouth. Many ways, whatever entered into the mouth, it is called kavalikara. Kavalikara. In Myanmar, there's people say, if something have, but can do nothing, can do operate, it is called Myanmar as a sea. You are looking like a monkey possess the coconut. Meow only yellow. Monkey have coconut, can do nothing. But I saw in the picture monkeys can open the coconuts also, you see, beating on the stone. Therefore, when I was in Sri Lanka, Sinhali people say not like Myanmar people. They never say, you are looking like monkey who has coconuts, cannot open it. They say, you are looking like a dog who has coconut. Not monkey. Monkey can break open coconut. But dogs can do nothing. Dogs also maybe, skins may be biting and removed, but cannot break down with the stone. So monkey can do like a human being. Monkeys are very clever, very close to human being. Therefore, in Pali words, use vanara. Nara means a human being. Va means similar to human being. Looking like a human being. This term is used, vanara. Vanara. Nara, a human being. Kavalikaro aharo imasa kayasa ahara pachena pacheyo. Yes. This is ordinary food is used. Okay. Kavalikaro aharo. So food is divided into three. Mental food and physical food. Different ways. This is a according to it, yeah. Kavalikara ahara. That is called oja. Oja. Kavalikara ahara is oja. Not all together. Nutriment, essence of nutriment. Nutriment essence. This oja. Oja is like vitamin. Vitamin. So, essence of nutriment. This oja, you know that oja is produced by four conditions. Some oja is produced by kama, some oja produced by citta, mind produce, utu produce, food also produce. This oja produced by four conditions, kamma, citta, utu, ahara. So, this oja is a support or producing support. The nutrient produce matters. Nutrient produce ahara smotana. Ahara smotana. Here I use only imasa kayasa. Ajani ahara smotana. Ahara smotana. And sometimes I use aharaja. Huh? Aharaja. So, orchards produce directly to nutrient produce matter. Orchards produce directly nutrient produce matter. But the other matter is support. Oja supported the matter, the remaining matter, which is produced the other conditions, citta kamabhon, citta bhon, utubhon. Okay? So we have to understand in this way. There is a special aharapache of this one. Kavanikaro aharo imasa kayasa. Here you see, kavanikaro aharo is ahara is belong to metta. Imasa kayasa also belong to metta. Metta to metta. Yeah. Metta to metta. It's belong to abhyagata to abhyagata, included abhyagata to abhyagata. Here does not concern any mind and mental state. So, kavanikaro aharo imasa kayasa ahara pacheena pacheo. This is a specific conditions here. Only one. Only one type of conditions. The type of condition is classified. See. Some are belong to born together, sahajata. Some are belong to no interval, anandara. In this way, type is different. According to their diet, they participate. Training together. So, ahara pachiyo, this is finished. Right? Then, indriya pachiyo. Before study indriya pachiyo, we must learn about indriya. Okay? For next lecture, you should read 22 indriyas. Okay, 22 indriyas. Controlling faculties, 22 indriyas. Some belong to metta, some belong to mind. So altogether, 22 controlling faculties. So we'll be explaining about indriya pachaya. Indriya pachaya. Indriya pachaya also some are similar to hetu cognizance. Some are cognizance. Some are similar to purichada or nisya. Some are similar to purichada or nisya. But the specific for indriya is the last one. Rupa jivita indriya kadada rupana indriya pachena pacheo. That is special for indriya. The others are conjunction with the other conditions. So, okay? So, there is some of the information. Now, we have a little news remained. If I rush, finish, tomorrow will be. But, but there's some more information I will keep. Because of, those are similar. We have studies about that. Therefore, I will refer, reference I will keep. Go to library, see, read books. So no news information. Only issues. But up to 20s will be. Okay? Now let me stop today.